In this video, we're going to look at what is meant by the phrase have depth in your answers. Fine. I've said that very frequently in this series. So I'm going to go slightly deeper on that. Fine. When I say have depth in your answers, have some meat, have something more than the headline. Let me give you a very simple example. What is very topical now is the GST, the Goods and Services Tax, which the government has been talking for a long time. A typical answer would be GST, the government is really struggling to pass the bill. It will simplify the tax structure in India. We have lots of direct and indirect taxes here, collected by states and central government. We do not know what exactly we are paying. And therefore, if we had one standardized GST, it would simplify life for the end consumer. It would also generate more revenue for the country and simplify the tax system. And so it's a very good answer. It's a good answer that I would expect from a 7th standard student. In the end, it means nothing. If you say this in your interview, they'll tell you there is a door marked exit, please go out there. Or they'll be thinking that. Right? So what is missing in this answer? Right? What are the tax systems that are currently there? What do you mean by direct and indirect? If I'm going to change that, then how will it generate more revenues for the government and be better for the consumer? If the government takes more money, that means I'm paying. How is it good for me? What do you mean by simplification? I'm paying only one tax. How is it going to be offset? How will the state government and central government share the revenues? Or what percentage will they split these to us? If it is such a brilliant thing, why have we not done this in the past? You're saying it is gridlocked and jammed. What is jammed? The government that is running the country, the one party has a simple majority. Why have they not passed it? Are they facing internal rebellion? No. And why have they not passed the bill? Why do I keep hearing the term joint session? What does it mean? What is exactly this legislative thing? How many votes do they need? What are they missing? How are they working? What is their principal opposition to it? What is the 1% difference that they keep talking about? What are they, in that new system, they're saying that states will not lose revenue or the states will be compensated for 3 years. How will they do that? There are some products which will be kept outside of the purview of GST for a longer period because a lot of states generate a lot of revenues from there. What are those products? You should know the answers to all these questions. You should know how to ask these questions. If you don't know these, then you're giving the headline from Times of India, right? Which is just not enough. So you should be able to answer all of these questions if you're going to say GST. So where do you get all these answers? From this particular thing, put GST, Quora. There's one first answer by one good Samaritan who's pretty much answered all these questions. Fine. And he's taken it upon himself to clarify things on GST. A hat tip to him. I don't even recall the name now, but it's a very good article. Go through that and you'll be able to find answers for most of these questions. Any new topic you take, any topic you claim to have expertise on, you should know this. To talk about hobbies, if you say my hobby is football, I like watching football, they'll ask you what's your favorite football team. And suppose you say Barcelona, and then they say who's your favorite football player? Say Messi. And if Messi is not playing, who will you support? What is the particular thing about Barcelona that impresses you? Who's been the coach that defines Barcelona? What have they seen in their tradition? And then you say stuff like Messi is good, other players are also good. Some forwards, Neymar is very good. Xavi plays well in midfield. Waffle. Xavi left a year ago. Fine. So that means you watch football for fun. Maybe you watch the World Cup, you watch the Euro, you watch the finals of the Champions League. You don't follow a team. You've got to say they're second on the table with a game in hand. If they win the game in hand, they will be first. The top three have created history by scoring the maximum number of goals. Their style, tiki-taka, was originally from Ajax Amsterdam, which was fine-tuned by Cruyff, built more by Rijkaard, taken into a monster shape by Guardiola. Now they have Enrique playing there. They had Ronaldinho who brought them prominence in the second cycle. And then Messi, who's just gone bonkers the way he's playing. You should know all of this. You should know their first 11 substitutes, what they have won in the last 10 years, who is their primary competitor, who do they play against most frequently, what is their head-to-head record against them, why are they your favorite team, all of that. And so get depth. You should have information, research, statistics, numbers, details, everything. If you say you're a volleyball player, what is the height of the net? What are the dimensions of the court? Which is the number one ranked team? How is India doing? Blah, 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 blah. So ask these questions, find those answers. Don't give the article that you can see on Times of India. And that basically says, you know something about this. You don't know all there is to know. You should know that if you're going to an interview. Keep that in mind.